All right, your next performer coming to the stage, not only an accomplished stand-up comedian, but also an improv artist. How about a big warm welcome for Suzanne Paquin?
Delta! Who wants to fuck me? There we go. Yes, and Paquin's the name. I am related. My sister is the Academy Award winner, Anna Paquin. Oh, yes, there we go. We met for the first time actually 10 years ago, so our relationship was a little strained. Unfortunately, we, you know, don't know that much about each other. I should say she doesn't really know a lot about me. I get to learn about her, though, through her movies, which is great. So I found out she's a bit of a slut with supernatural powers. So that's enjoyable. So it's kind of fun when you sort of look at your sister's life, you know, down there. I'm in North Delta. She rides in a limo, I ride the bus. She gets to be an X-Men and I work at Science World. So there we go. Yes, you can catch me in the bubble show at 2:20. Oh man. So Science World, yes, the best non-medical birth control in the city. In case you're wondering, ladies, about what enough to have kids, come on down! It's great, spend about 9 hours, it's a delight, huh? Because they're so cute, aren't they? They're precious. And then they do that high-pitched wah! Scream where even dogs are like, what the fuck was that? And it's so great, because I'll see one, and it's beautiful, I'm all maternal, it's just so wonderful, and then they go wah! And then my ovaries just go no, fuck you, it's not going to happen. For whatever reason, my ovaries are Spanish, but, when I can, I'll go out, I'll go partying with the girls, get a little wasted, be on the dance floor. Last time I was up, it was really great, it's like, I'm on the floor, I'm like, woo! I should pee! Now, I made it into the bathroom all by myself, but of course, the goddamn door's broken, so I have to keep it closed with my head. And now I'm just hovering because there's no way that seat is going anywhere near my ass. So I gotta try to aim using sound. Ah, crap, that's tough. Oh shit, that's my purse. And that's like, oh yeah, there we go, yeah. Pretty much the only thing going through my head right now, hope to God I pulled my panties down. Try to convince your girlfriend to put your wet panties in her purse. Because guys, you got your fellow man, a little wet gun to the front pocket. Don't worry, Bob, I got it covered. When I first started going out to the bars, the big fashion item was the bodysuit with the snaps in the crotch. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, huh? Beginning of the night, shabling, shabling. I look good, yeah. 14 drinks in, you're like, oh yeah, yeah, me, shabling, shabling. I gotta do it up. The snaps go on this thing. Sometimes go bang. Ow, the skull is small. Get into the bar, 30 seconds in. Shang, lang, 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 lang. Oh, thank God I put my bra on. But I don't think you can meet people in bars, so I've gone on the internet. I'm a busy girl, so there we go. I'm doing internet dating. The best social experiment ever, if you want. Just go look at the photos. That's my favorite part. I'll admit it, I put my headshot up. I want the best possible picture out there. What I love are the guys' photos. Because there's a photo of the guy from about 150 feet away, wearing a motorcycle helmet and some sunglasses. You know? Or it's a picture of his dog. That's nice. Or it is a very nice photo of him. He's in a suit, he's standing tall, he's smiling. And if you look really close on his shoulder, you can see the hand with the painted nails. Because that's his old girlfriend that he ripped out of the photo! Because I figure, guys, that is the only time you will stay still for a photo, is when we got you. Maybe the only other time, hey, you're drunk with your buddies. It's like, oh man, Steve's passed out. Get the camera, I'm gonna put my dick next to his head. Like my balls are in his face. So I went one good step up. I slept with a coworker. Yeah, that's good times, especially when it doesn't work out. get to see him every day? He's like, I know what your penis looks like. I know what your face looks like when you come. Too bad you can't say the same for me. But my best story ever was the man I was sleeping with came over and we were intimate and had a shower. He put on my robe and he goes in the pocket of my robe and he finds a Kleenex and he goes, oh! And I'm like, you just licked my ass. A Kleenex is grossing you out. You just had your tongue in my mouth. This is dried snot poo comes out of there. I guess that's why I have so many cats now. And they're all female, which is great. It's so wonderful. And two of them are in heat at the moment. Yeah, have you ever experienced one cat in heat? At like 2 o'clock in the morning, it's like, you wake up, this big cat ass in your face. It's so brutal because I phone the vet. I'm like, the vet's gonna know what to do. The vet will know what to do. You know what the vet told me? Well, you can take a Q-tip. That's right, folks. It's a little kitty dildo. Ding, 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 ding. Oh, I need some glue. Wait a second. Oh, it's like, I'm not gonna go there for the cat. I'd rather go there for myself. Really, come on. So it's so brutal because the other night, like, two of them were at it. It was like, ring, 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 ring. All of a sudden it stops, eh? So I'm curious as hell, I get up out of bed, I flick on the light, and there they were, licking each other, helping each other out. Lesbian cats, people, I have lesbian cats! I'm not sure whether to dress them up in the parade, so I grab the camera, a little pussy on pussy action. Woo! Mama needs to make some money. All right, folks, thanks so much. Remember, Bubble Show 220. We'll see you again tonight.
Two comics left. Your next comic coming to the stage. Been doing comedy in several genres for quite some time. Not only stand-up, but also improviser. Big round of applause. Okay. Christine Lippa, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, thank you very much. I think these cheese commercials are going a bit far. You want your girlfriend to leave? Stop sipping your dick in the cheese! Your boyfriend being a pain in the ass? Stop stuffing those cubes of fat up your ass! Just my opinion. I was in Canadian Tire the other day, just walking to Canadian Tire. I'm looking for kindling, right? Looking for kindling. So I go up to this guy, I go, hi, excuse me, because, you know, they're fast, because you have to catch them when they're there, right? They're just really fucking fast. So I go, hi, excuse me, do you have kindling? And he goes, what? I'm like, kindling, do you have kindling? He's like, what's that? I go, and I'm going fucking cry. I go, kindling. You know, kindling, you start a fire with kindling. It's like small pieces of wood, and you put newspaper, and you can put the small pieces of wood on, and then you put the log on top of that, right? He goes, oh, you mean fire sticks. Check camping. It's like, what do you fucking quest for fire, boy? What the fuck do you mean fire sticks? You know? So I go over there, and it's like matches. Oh, I just felt like ripping his head off. And I go, you know, it's like, fire sticks, you know? What am I gonna do, come back here in the summer and go, give me fans? You fans? What are those? You know, a fan that, you know, twirls the air around. But, oh, you mean air twirlers. Yeah, check out camping. Fuck off. And it's like, you know, you walk into any, this is what gets me about retail, and you know, anywhere. In the world, you know, you walk in and you go in February, you say, you know, into the bay or something, hey, I'm going on a cruise, do you have any bathing suits? What? Oh. We had some, I think. We don't really know. It's just like, are you like a fucking bathing suit? What, you don't have one left over from August, you know? And then it's like, you know, you go up the, and then, but you walk in March for a bathing suit. It's like, hey, do you have any bathing suits? Well, they're gone. They're like, what did you decide the minute I walked out of the store that you're gonna put the fucking things on sale? Is that just call up everybody? Lipa's left the store, sell all the bathing suits. Oh God, commercials for kids' toys are getting to me these days too. I remember when I was a little kid, you know, Christmas was simpler. I wanted a Chatty Cathy doll. Anybody remember Chatty Cathy doll? Yeah, you know, a doll. You know, it had a string in the back. You just pulled, you know, the string, and it would go, "Hi, I'm Chatty Cathy." Record spinning in the back, right? So I wanted a Chatty Cathy doll. I asked my mom. I go, "Mom, can I have a Chatty Cathy? Can I have a Chatty Cathy? Can I have a Chatty Cathy?" And my mom would say, "No! We didn't have those during the Krieg. Why don't you take a string and tie it around your friend Barbara? Und Kohl. She'll talk."
I don't think that's legal in Canada, Mom.
Yeah, well, if Hitler was alive, huh?
I'm just like, Ipsnit on the Hitlering. I gotta go to school. I'm a Nazi at school, you know?
To this day. She'll say that. You know, going shopping, you know, save on foods, whatever. It'll be a big lineup at the, you know, the checkout thing, right? We're standing there, and I can just feel her simmering. You know, just feel it. You know, you feel it. You're just like, fuck. You know? And then she'll go to me, not really quietly, "If Hitler was around." Like, holy crap, they almost forgot, except for now you bring it up again, you know? Was alive, what would make your life better if Hitler was alive?
Yeah, but we have a special Brussels sprouts in the back for Mrs. Lipa only.
You know? What would make your life better, you know? My mom though was the, besides, you know, the accent that would just, you know, bring back, you know, the war dead, she was the sexy mom on the block, you know? She was the sexy mom. She'd out in the garden, you know, gardening away in her little shorts. La 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 la. Oh, hello, Mr. Dorash, how are you? Hmm? No, these aren't shorts. These are hot pants.
It's just like, whatever you say, Mrs. Lepa.
You know, my friends would come over and my friend would call up and go, "You want to go ride bikes, right?" So, you know, I'd be upstairs, I'd be getting changed, and you know, the doorbell would ring, and I'd go, "Oh, it's Gordon, I'll get it." My mom, no, I'll get it. "Hello, Gordon. No, Christine's not ready yet. Why don't you come upstairs? Gordon." Hmm? No. These are hot pants. "Would you like a North American snack treat, Gordon? Maybe ding dong, a Twinkie, a hoo hoo?" Gordon just fucks off, you know? I go, "Hey, where's Gordon?" And he goes, "I don't know, he had to go home." So I call him up, I go, "Hey, I thought we were gonna go riding bikes." He goes, "I can't come over to your place anymore." I'm like, "Why not?" Because every time I watch Hogan's Heroes now, I get a boner. My mother would sunbathe nude on our deck when friends would come over. You know, there she is, just bang, bang, fa-foomf, you know? It's that big old muff, fa-foomf, you know, that European bush that spread from Italy to fucking Poland, you know? Just fa-foomf. And a little bit, bang, you know? My friends, "Ah!" My mother stands up, "What's the matter? Huh? Haven't seen a grown woman naked before? If Hitler was alive." You guys have been a lot of fun. Thanks very much.
Christine Lipa. All right, the final performer of the evening, you guys, are you ready? Let's do this! This next comic coming to the stage, you may have seen her at the Halifax Comedy Festival or the Winnipeg Comedy Festival. She's the only comic that's made the transition from nun to comic. That's right, she's an ex-nun, ladies and gentlemen, Jackie O'Keefe. Woo!
much. So yes, it's true, I'm an unschooled flunky. And I suppose being a former nun would make Jesus my ex. Actually, it was a smooth breakup. I'm still on good terms with the family. Still visit his dad's house every Sunday. But just in case you're wondering, when we split, he did get everything. I should have known better than to trust a long-haired Sandalwood hippie who lived at home till he was 33. Last weekend, some of the gals in my apartment building thought it'd be fun to have the ex-nun at a lingerie party. The first thing they have us do is to pull out a sensuality score test, and at the end of the testing, everybody else has given out their scores. It's like 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. Gets to me, it's like 28. And a half. And if that wasn't pathetic enough, I got beat up by a 15-year-old. She got 29. And just backtracking a bit here by applause, or any of you curious to know how I got the 28 and a half points? Yeah, I thought as much, a bunch of sickos. But since you asked, I got the first 10 points because I once purchased a pair of athletic socks from La Senza. And the other 18 and a half points because another time I danced erotically for my cat. He's still in therapy. In addition to the whole ex-nun thing, another weird little quirky thing about myself is that I lost my virginity at the tender age of 39. Did I mention I turned 40 this year? And I know you're all amazed and astounded to hear that, because I'm sure the first three words that popped into your head when I walked out on stage were hot sex kitten. You know, folks, I had one New Year's resolution this year. It was clear. Do not become a 40-year-old virgin. It's like, what can I say? That movie really touched me. Which led to me touching other people. And I just kind of want to do a public service thing here. You know, for all of those suicide bombers out there who are being promised 72 virgins for blowing stuff up, let me just tell you, taking a virgin, let alone 72, is simply not all it's cracked up to be. I also want to state for the record that I am not, you know, particularly picking on any religious group of suicide bombers when I talk about this. I'm just talking about suicide bombers in general. Depressed, and no 12-step program could help me, so I saw my doctor and we got it down to one step. Drugs. I was on this stuff called Zoloft, which is an antidepressant, and being on Zoloft completely changed my life. I finally felt for the first time ever that I'd found a perfect martini chaser. And felt good enough to feed my cat. I'd just like to state for the record that none of these jokes were tested on any animals, and no animals were harmed in the writing of these jokes. Speaking of depression, I guess this is a good time to talk about my mom. Not saying my mom was tough, but in the old days, her idea for getting away from it all was to spend a week away at army camp. Wearing my dad, she won a rifle shooting championship. That's right, well, your moms were baking your little cupcakes for your little bake sales. My mom was blowing pop cans to smithereens. And the kids at school used to tease me with a class of like, oh, your mom wears army boots. I'm like, duh. How many rifle shooting championships has your mom won wearing her stilettos? Actually, it's kind of a bit of a break to go and live with the nuns for a while, because they let me sleep in until 5:30 on Sundays. And the nuns didn't make me do push-ups. Seriously, my mom is quite a resourceful person. Recently, she had a problem with fleas. And while she had her Hoover 8000 out, she thought to herself, why don't I get to the source? The source being the cat. She cannot understand why she wound up with 4-inch lacerations, 18 stitches, and a completely treaded vacuum system. You know, there are certain truths in the universe you just don't mess with. For example, we all know E equals MC squared. It's also quite well documented that the only organisms that will survive a nuclear holocaust are cockroaches and Cher. And we now know with certainty that cat plus human plus vacuum equals emergency blood transfusion. So I too have been dabbling in the internet dating thing for a while, and what bugs me about internet dating is the profiles. You know, they only allow you to accentuate the positive. There's nowhere in there to say, like with one guy I dated, that he was a rageaholic, a raging alcoholic, and secretly in love with his mother. And those were his good points. You know, it's getting to the point where I'm going to start my own website. It's going to be called www.imneuroticbuthonestsowillyoudateme.anyway.com. And I can see the ads on that site. You know, I'm 42, still living at home, collect a disability check, but on the plus side, all of my multi-personalities are fantastic in bed. If any of this interests you, let's meet for coffee at my parents' place. So because I've been so successful in Canadian show business, I have recently redecorated my apartment using the method of feng shui, and I chose the feng shui method mainly because it's been a huge part of my Irish, French, Canadian heritage. I'll just let you catch up with me. For those of you who don't know, feng shui is actually the Chinese decorating method where you use furniture placement and the use of color to attract positive qi energy into your home. So I'm going to pass along a few tips. Tip number one, for a restful night's sleep, you should never place your bed in the middle of a staircase. Secondly, to create warmth in your living room, it's always best to steer clear of black paint and images of Satan. And finally, as a tool to promote harmonious relationships with your neighbors, it's never a good idea to use your balcony as a crystal meth lab. And in order to finance all this redecorating, I applied for a homeowner's loan to a financial institution, and oddly enough, I was rejected. I guess not everybody considers being a Canadian comic an asset, apparently. And I can't say the name of the institution, but let's just say they gave me the royal runaround. They royally messed up my finances. And they were a royal pain in the butt. It's like, oh, what the hell? I'm a Canadian comic. What are they gonna go after, my George Foreman grill? I'm crying out loud. In case you didn't figure out, it was RBC, Royal Bank of Canada, woohoo. Friend of comics. Anyway, you know the old Royal Bank slogan, and I know I'm dating myself, I'm Generation X, it's my prerogative, but the old jingle, you know, can do, at the Royal Bank you say can do. Well, in my case it was more like, can't do, at the Royal Bank we say fuck you. Need to paint too bad, need new floor so sad. Forget that kidney for your dad. That's why